We were given two graphs and eight equations or eight functions. We want to match the correct equation to the correct graph. Notice all of the equations are in the form of f of x or y equals b to the power of x plus k, meaning they're all exponential functions where b, the base, is greater than 0, b can't equal 1, and if b is greater than 1, we have exponential growth. Notice in the first row, all the equations represent exponential growth, and if b is between 0 and 1, we have exponential decay. Notice the second row, all represent exponential decay. When we have exponential functions in the form of b to the power of x plus k, k will shift the graph up or down. Notice in the first row, all the bases are 2, but the value of k is different. And for the second row, all the bases are 1/2, but all the values of k are different. Looking at the graphs for a moment, notice the red graph increases from left to right, which means we have exponential growth. Also notice the horizontal asymptote is not y equals 0, it's y equals negative 2. And the graph on the right, the blue graph, is decreasing, and therefore we have exponential decay, and the horizontal asymptote is y equals negative 3. So we should recognize, because the graph on the left is exponential growth, the correct equation must be from the first row because the base is greater than 1, and we should recognize the equation for the graph on the right of the blue graph will come from the second row because all the bases are 1/2 and we have exponential decay. And now let's go to decimals.com and see how the value of k affects the graph of an exponential growth or exponential decay function. On the right, we have the graph of y equals 2 to the power of x plus k, where k is equal to 0. Notice the horizontal asymptote is y equals 0. And notice when k is positive, the graph is shifted up k units. And when k is negative, or we have minus k, the graph is shifted down k units, all of which affect the horizontal asymptote. And now let's look at exponential decay. Let's set k back to 0. And now look at the graph of y equals 1/2 to the power of x plus k. Again, notice when k is positive, the graph is shifted up k units. And when k is negative, the graph is shifted down. Going back to our problem, for the red graph on the left, because we have exponential decay and the horizontal asymptote is y equals negative 2, the exponential growth function has been shifted down 2 units. So we know the base must be greater than 1 and k is going to be negative 2, which indicates the correct equation should be y equals 2 to the power of x minus 2. But let's also verify this by determining two points on the red graph. Let's use the x-intercept of 1, 0, and the y-intercept of 0, negative 1. Looking at the equation y equals 2 to the power of x minus 2, notice when x is equal to 0, y is equal to 2 to the power of 0 minus 2. 2 to the power of 0 is 1. 1 minus 2 is negative 1. Notice this point is on the graph. And when x is equal to positive 1, y is equal to 2 to the power of 1 minus 2. 2 to the first is equal to 2. 2 minus 2 is 0. And notice the graph does contain the point 1, 0, verifying we have the correct equation for the graph on the left. Let's go ahead and label the graph with y equals 2 to the power of x minus 2. And now looking at the exponential decay function on the right, because the horizontal asymptote is y equals negative 3, the graph has been shifted down 3 units, and therefore k is negative 3 this time, which indicates the correct equation should be y equals 1/2 to the power of x minus 3. But again, let's verify this by selecting two points on the blue graph. Let's use the y-intercept of 0, negative 2. Let's also use this point here, the point negative 1, negative 1. So using our equation y equals 1/2 to the power of x minus 3, notice when x is equal to 0, we have y equals 1/2 to the power of 0 minus 3, which is 1 minus 3, or negative 2. This point is on the graph. And when x is negative 1, y is equal to 1/2 to the power of negative 1 minus 3. Well, 1/2 to the power of negative 1 is equal to 2 divided by 1 to the power of 1, which is 2. And 2 minus 3 is negative 1. Again, the point is on the graph. We do have the correct equation. Let's go ahead and label the graph as y equals 1/2 to the power of x minus 3. I hope you found this helpful.